philosophy, which old one race superior and another inferior, is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned. Everywhere is war. It's a war that until they're no longer first class and second class citizens of any nation, until the color of a man's skin is of no more significance than the color of his eyes, Mr. War. That until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all without regard to race, Mr. War. That until that day, the dream of lasting peace, world citizenship, rule of international morality, will remain in but a fleeting illusion to be pursued but never attained. Now everywhere is war. And until the ignoble and unhappy regime that hold our brothers in Angola, in Mozambique, South Africa, subhuman bondage, have been toppled, totally destroyed, well, everywhere is war. War in the east, war in the west, war up north, war down south, war, war, rumors of a war, and until that day, the African continent will not know.
Today we will explore the introduction to the foundations in education. Please have your notebooks ready to jot down information of interest. Introduction to education is an important course that helps new or potential student teachers to understand what schools are like, current practices and policies, and how children learn. A foundations of education course may address some of the same topics, but the focus is always on understanding how things became the way they are by studying the history and underpinnings of current practices. Assumptions about human beings, who they are and what they value, are the driving forces of education in the past and the present. By learning to look at education with a critical, historical perspective that questions current policies and practices, student teachers equip themselves to be thoughtful participants in the profession. While many disciplines inform the foundations of education, it is their interaction rather than their isolation that contributes to what people accept as the way things are. By understanding the dynamic nature of education, student teachers look not only at the way things are, but also beyond the present to how things got to be and the way things ought to be. Such a study is dynamic, interactive, participatory, and exciting. What is education? What are the basic thoughts about education? How have Jamaicans conceptualized education? What has been the history of education in general in Jamaica? How does the history of education influence the future of education in Jamaica? What should education be like in the future, both worldwide and in Jamaica? What are some of the social influences on education? How have philosophies influenced education? How has sociology influenced education? How has psychology as a discipline influenced the learning and instruction process? A variety of interactive learning approaches will be used in this course. These approaches will enhance your ability to generate ideas, discuss, ask, and answer questions, develop social skills, and analyze and critique readings and discussion topics. Student teachers' ability to evaluate and justify their opinions is very important. The Foundations of Education course consists of disciplines such as sociology, philosophy, psychology, and the history of education. These disciplines assist in constructing the meaning we make of schools and teaching learning practices in schools. Schools and schooling practices are affected by several factors, including the everyday conditions of society, prevalent ideologies, current content and pedagogical practices, key social issues, and the knowledge and attitudes of professional educators and other participants in schools. You will be helped to use and understand the relationships between material conditions, ideologies, schooling conditions, curriculum, and pedagogy to address issues that you may face as teachers. This course will broaden your thinking on how the characteristics of the larger community in which the school is placed have a direct impact on the school's conditions, administration, curriculum, pedagogy, and assessment practice. One of the primary aims is to enable student teachers to establish their own philosophy of education. You will first look at classical, modern, and postmodern philosophies and end by critically reflecting on education today. Today we will go through a short PPT, then you will watch a video by Plato, one of the founding fathers of philosophy. The video is called The Allegory of the Cave. Please pay attention, after which we will discuss our understanding of the video and its relation to education. PPT presentation. What is philosophy? Did someone say love of wisdom? What is wisdom? If you are thinking that it means having good experience and judgment, you are correct. This knowledge will make you happy. Another word for knowledge is episteme, otherwise called epistemology. As we search, we ponder about our own lives. What is my philosophy? What is the truth about who you are and why you want to be a teacher?